Hey everyone, welcome back. This is another off-the-shelf Let's Play. I'm Scorch82, and this time around, it's the first God of War for the PS2, also brought to us by Sony. I know I went a little out of order by doing God of War 2 first, and this one is actually one that I got it like right when it came out, and it was a pretty fun game, but at the time, I had a lot going on, and I don't think I ever got around to finishing it. Some of the puzzles in this one are a little more frustrating than the ones in the second one, so it was a little more difficult to get through. But nonetheless, it's actually still pretty similar, so let's get right into it. I'm going to play on the normal difficulty.
The gods of Olympus have abandoned me. Now there is no hope.
And Kratos cast himself from the highest mountain in all of Greece. After 10 years of suffering, 10 years of endless nightmares, it would finally come to an end. Death would be his escape from madness. But it had not always been this way. Kratos had once been a champion of the gods.
Foul beast! I will send you back to the depths of Hades!
So these guys should look a little familiar. It'll be kind of interesting to actually play this one now, given the fact that we've already gone through the second one and seen the events that happened after this. So it's kind of like viewing the story like before everything happened, after you've already seen what happened in the future. It's kind of nice. So they'll give you a little bit of training on how to do certain things. The moves are pretty much the same, except with the exception of this one, the action button is R2 instead of R1. Slightly more annoying, especially if you're playing on a PS3 controller, because as you may know, they turn the L2 and R2 buttons into triggers, and it makes it a little harder to push rapidly when you need to. But, still have the blades, only in this one I think they're called the Blades of Chaos, instead of the Blades of Athena. Look at some of the same moves are still similar. We're going to start off this one in the Agean Sea, 3 weeks before we supposedly off ourselves. Okay. So you can see the life bar looks somewhat similar, but only now we have a gauge to represent the number of red orbs we have. Instead of it being a counter, it's like a bar. Bust open this hatch here. Head on down. Press and hold R2 to open chests. As always, destroy everything to get the orbs. Ship, she's sinking. Holy shit. Destroy the beds for orbs, too. Hold L1 to block. No problem. We'll see why. Oh, snap! Rears its head back. He's gonna chomp at you. So basically, you're just gonna want to hit the Hydra head. It goes down. He'll drop health every time you do a good amount of damage to him. This is kind of meant to be a pretty easy, like, mini-boss, kind of. Usually we'll chomp twice. They're nice to us in this one. They give you a health gauge for the bosses. At least in this one, this particular level, they give you a health gauge on the boss. Press circle to initiate the minigame when it appears above an enemy's head. So let's do that. Same as before, push the buttons when they show up on the screen. That one, it was a little easier. Again, it's random. Okay, so let's start by crossing the beams. In this game, it's a lot easier to fall off, but you can save yourself by tapping X quickly. I don't like the way they do the camera angling, though. It's kind of annoying. You have to use your shadow to kind of tell where you are. But walking slow will also keep you from falling, which helps. So I was actually wrestling with whether or not I wanted to do this, I'm getting about this way.
Stay away! Stay away from me!
I was wrestling with whether or not I wanted to do this game, since I hadn't actually had a chance to finish it, and it did kind of annoy me towards the end.
I know who you are, Spartan. I know what you've done. I would rather die than be saved by you.
Okay, so that guy would rather stay in there. Fuck him, we don't care. But I figure since I finished the second one after a long time, and I plan on doing the third one when it comes out, this one was only fitting that we take care of it. So this one you can hit the innocents for health if you need it. Harpies will work the same way. Grab them and tear their wings off. An attempt to grab them at least. We don't spare no innocents around here. I'm tired of this. It's a terrible way to go. It's like 20 times worse than pulling the wings off a fly. Take that! Eventually, across these doors here. Pull this up. Get ourselves some orbs. This one, and get another treasure chest. Yay. And which way do we go? Supposed to be. There it is. The Hydra head just pops out and goes for it. And he's gonna eat us. So when he does this, just tap on the circle button. Counter. Fuck yo! Does that, you can block it or jump. Find it easier to just block it. That one, he'll slam against the three sides that he can reach. Just avoid that. But not like that. That'll shut you up, won't it? Exactly how you can block a giant head swinging at you is beyond me, but that's okay. I'm not whole bitch. Pattern is usually the same. So Sometimes you want him to do this. Does way more damage just sitting there taking it.